Let us search the old highways. What an appropriate quote by Hilda Doolittle to start with. From Cox's Bazar, Bangladesh, the Grand Trunk Road runs approximately 3,670 km to Kabul, Afghanistan, via Chittagong and Dhaka in Bangladesh, Kolkata, Allahabad, Delhi, and Amritsar in India, and Lahore, Rawalpindi, and Peshawar in Pakistan. And here comes the name of Sher Shah Suri, an ethnic Afghan, founder of the Suri dynasty, who rose to his glory to such an extent that his nemesis Humayun, on his death, called him Ustadi Badshashan, or the teacher of kings. Born in Sasaram, Bihar, starting his life as a soldier of the lowest military rank, Farid Khan became so powerful to even supersede the mighty Mughal Empire in 1538. A dexterous general, with his precautious strategies, became a proficient administrator. During his brief rule of 7 years, he set up various administrative and economic reforms, along with the extension of Chandragupta's royal road, Uttarapath, during the 16th century, which later came to be known as Sadak-e-Sher Shah. This road not only accelerated travel and postal communication, but also acted as one of the major trade routes. Known to be the second Taj Mahal of India, the tomb of Sher Shah Suri is a prominent tourist attraction in Sasaram, a small city of Rohtas district in the state of Bihar. Planned by the architect Mir Muhammad Aliwal Khan, this red sandstone mausoleum is a brilliant example of Indo-Islamic architecture. The tomb was completed 3 months after the death of Sher Shah in August 1545 by his son Jalal Khan or Islam Shah Suri. With a height of 122 feet, this Pathan architecture standing in the middle of an artificial lake is connected through a stone bridge. Inside the large octagonal chamber lies the tomb of this ingenious Afghan ruler who got seriously injured by a gunpowder explosion during the siege of Kalinjar Fort and died in the accident.